It's another windy day.
For God so loved the world that he gave his only begotten Son, that whosoever believes in him should not perish, but have everlasting life. As always, the topic about this is about the Lord Jesus Christ, the Son of God, the Lamb of God, which take away the sin of the world. When we quote, when we speak, we are speaking out of the King James 1611 Bible. It is of no opinion, it is of no man, but of God. Inspiration to write by men. Jesus says in John 5:43, I am come in my Father's name, and ye receive me not. If another shall come in his own name, him ye will receive. Understand, we're going to look at the Lord Jesus Christ today as the I am. Not the I was. Not that I will.
Amen.
He is the I am that today. The I am that the Jehovah God of the Bible spoke to Moses when Moses said, what shall I say to the children of Israel when they ask for your name? He said, you to tell them I am. And Jesus shows up on this planet, born in a manger, speaks to the people of Israel, and proclaims, I am. And at one point in time, when he professes, I am, the Jews take up stones, were going to stone him on his very words that he proclaimed that he was Jehovah, Lord God. That will go against a teaching of many religions that proclaim that Jesus is not God. That maybe a woman is God. Maybe a man is God. But the Lord Jesus Christ, the I am, is God. And he says right here in the very first passage that we read that you're not willing to receive his name, but you'll receive another name. You will go about other names besides the name where it's given by men whereby ye must be saved. Let me give you some of them names today. Mary. Donald Trump. Pope whatever. Those are names that God does not recognize into the heaven, into the glory, into New Jerusalem. It is not a name that's recognized for salvation by God, only by the Lord Jesus Christ. And Jesus said, I am come in my Father's name, and ye receive me not. If another shall come in his own name, him ye will receive. You're more ready to receive anybody else but the Lord Jesus Christ. Tons of thousands of names out there. And you're not ready to receive the Lord Jesus Christ. And yet, the name of the Lord Jesus Christ is the way of salvation. It is God, the Lamb of God, which take away the sin of the world. These president candidates, the president that is, cannot take away your sin. These religion folks, people, these religions, priests and pastors and what ministers and whatever they be, they cannot take away your sin. Only by the blood of the Lord Jesus Christ can your sins be removed by the gospel that Christ died for your sins. He was buried according to the scripture. And he arose the third day according to the scripture. He also says, and Jesus said unto them, I am the bread of life. He that cometh to me shall never hunger. He that believeth on me shall never thirst. Jesus Christ is the bread of life. Now, man needs three essential things to live. And one of them is not a cell phone. Another one's not video games. Man needs air, water, and food. And Jesus said, I am the bread of life. One of the essentials that you need for and not as an oral depassant. When you receive the Lord Jesus Christ, the spirituality of you, the soul of you, is satisfied for all eternity. Now, the flesh may not be. You may have breakfast and need lunch and need supper. But when it comes to soul part of you and the spiritual part of you, when you believe on the Lord Jesus Christ as your Savior, the bread of life, you will be satisfied. Religion cannot do that. Because religion, you must go back and redo and re-give and re-climb and re-pilgrimage and redo and and just keep on doing it over in an endless cycle that will end up in the lake of fire that burns for all eternity. But when it comes to salvation, when it comes to the desire and the need of your soul, Jesus Christ is the bread of life, the Lamb of God which take away the sin of the world. The Jews then murmured at him because he said, "I am the bread of life which came down from heaven." You need the bread that came down from heaven, not from a closet and not from a priest's hands. That is not Jesus Christ. That is a pastry item made by a group of nuns, which has nothing to do with heavenliness. Jesus Christ is the bread of God that came from heaven to satisfy your soul. It is no way to be taken by your mouth to be saved. And then when he concludes in this chapter, he says, "I am the bread of life." It's just plain and simple. I am. That thing that the church will give you is a little round wafer. That's not Jesus. Jesus was much taller. Jesus was of brown skin texture. Jesus had a face. That wafer does not have a face. And if you were to preclude that that is Jesus, and your priest says it is Jesus, by hocus pocus and magical tricks and for kids and everything, then you proclaim that becomes the literal body of Jesus Christ, my friend, you are a cannibal. In order to be a cannibal, you gotta kill somebody. That's murder. And then you hide signs on international that says, "Thou shalt not kill, but I kill in order to eat a body." You're no better than an African. Jesus never said to take his body and eat it. But he said, "I am the bread of life." Then spake Jesus again unto them, saying, "I am the light of the world. He that follows me shall not walk in darkness, but shall have the light of life." Friend, if that sun up there in the sky blew out, if that sun died, life will be gone. You would have an ultimate global warming. You would have a global darkness of no plant life, of no life at all. So not only is Jesus the source, of your food, but Jesus is the source of your light. And Jesus said, "I am the light of the world." That light that you see at death is the light of a train coming at you. That is not the light of Jesus Christ. The true light is the gospel that Jesus Christ died for your sins. was buried according to the scriptures, and arose again the third day according to the scriptures. That is the light. What is the light? To show you how God wants you to be saved. The light of Jesus Christ, when he says, I am the way, the truth, and the life. No man cometh unto the Father but by me. That is the light. That is that heavenly light to show upon you God's way in darkness. How do I get around in the dark? You grab a flashlight. You grab a candle to see your way. How do I find my way in darkness into heaven? You grab the light, the Lord Jesus Christ. Jesus said, I am the light in this darkened and filthy world. If you don't believe this world is filthy, you don't believe this world is in darkness, you haven't lived long. Jesus also said, I am one that bear witness of myself, and the Father that sent me bears witness of me. The greatest testimony that Jesus says is from God the Father, who sent his Son. For God so loved the world that he gave his only begotten Son, that whosoever believes in him should not perish, but have everlasting life. The true witness. How do I know that Jesus is the way? Because God is witness to it. God is Jehovah. And if Jehovah's a witness, he's a witness to the fact that Jesus Christ is the way, the truth, and the life. It ain't about watchtowers. It's about Jesus Christ. Jesus said again, I am one that bears witness of myself, and the Father has sent me, beareth witness of me. Father, witness, Jehovah, witness, that Jesus Christ is who he is. The Savior of the world, the Son of God, the Lamb of God, which take away the sin of the world. There is no other name given amongst men that whereby ye must be saved. I say therefore unto you, that ye shall die in your sins. For if ye believe not that I am he, ye shall die in your sins. I don't know how I can make that verse any simpler out of the Bible. That ain't my words. That is the word. It would be in red if you had a red letter Bible. Jesus said, if you do not believe who he is, you do not believe in the I am, you will die in your sins, and you will be placed into a place called hell for all eternity. The way out of the judgment and the wrath of God, the lake of fire, is the I am, and that's Jesus Christ. There is no other way. And we've already just read before that the testimony of Jesus Christ is sure by the Father's witness. And the Father witnesses Jesus Christ is true. And Jesus said, if you do not believe that he is who he proclaims to be, and he is, you will die in your sins. You will be in the wrath of God. And the wrath of God, John the Baptist speaks, he that believeth on the Son has everlasting life. He that believeth not the Son shall not see life, but the wrath of God abiding upon him. Now, some people do not want me to preach hell. But hell must be preached, because that's where you're going unless you receive Christ as your Savior. Know Christ, you burn. Know Christ, you go into glory. You've got to believe that he is the I Am. The I Am is God. Jesus said, verily, Abraham was, I am. And at that point, the Jews picked up stones, and they were going to stone Jesus by the capital punishment of their time prescribed by the law. Now, what they were going to do, what they were going to do was they were going to kill Jesus for making himself equal with God. I'll give the Jews credit one thing over the Jehovah's Witnesses. They knew what Jesus said. They knew that Jesus proclaimed to be God. And they received the testimony because they were going to kill him. They don't receive the testimony and try to sell magazines and another door outside the fire door to be saved. But once you enter that fire door, there's no other exit. Jesus said, I'll read it again so we don't get it wrong. Jesus said unto him, verily, verily, I say unto you, before Abraham was, I am. Before Abraham was God, in the beginning, God. Jesus just proclaimed in John 8, I am the Father. We've already read that Jesus said the Father testified, witnesses of who Jesus is. Again, I'm reading from the Bible. Well, I don't believe the Bible. Well, you're going to stand before God as an ignorant fool that'll be cast into hell because this is the word of life. This is the bread of life. This word that is in my hands, according to John 1:1, is the Lord Jesus Christ. And Jesus Christ is the word. And you can only be saved by the Bible. Faith cometh by hearing, and hearing by the word of God. And Jesus proclaimed, I am before Abraham. So Jesus is God. And the Father testifies to that. As long as I am in the world, I am the light of the world. There's that light again. There's that light in darkness. We stand here with a heavenly flashlight. It is the middle of darkness. I turn the light of Jesus Christ upon you and you want to run like a bunch of cockroaches. You don't want the light. It burns your eyeballs. You want to get rid of the rain. Yet, this will not kill you. The darkness will. This will give you life. Life set forth by Jesus Christ and Jesus Christ alone. Jesus said for judgment, I am come into this world, that they which see not might see, and that they might which see might be made blind. You may tell me, judge not, lest you be judged. But you'll stand before Jesus Christ one day to be judged. You better not stand guilty. If you stand guilty before the Lord Jesus Christ, there's nothing but condemnation. There is nothing but the wrath of God. Jesus has come into this world that if you want to do what God wants you to do, He will give you light. If you choose to not hear the word and do it your way, any other way, you will be blinded. See, God gives you the free will. Do right or do wrong. If you want to do wrong, God will say, go ahead and do it. I'm not going to force you. I'm not going to make you. But when you die and appear before the judgment, you will be guilty. And ladies and gentlemen of the Daytona Beach Farmers Market, you cannot tell God I never knew because I just broke your alibi. He will tell you I sent a loudmouth preacher in your midst, in the middle of you, to preach my gospel, and he preached the truth, he preached the way, he preached the life, and no man cometh unto the Father but by the Lord Jesus Christ. I sent week after week after week, I sent my word into your ears. He that has ears, let him hear. Today, Jesus Christ is I Am. Jesus said, then said Jesus unto them again, verily, verily, I say unto you, I am the door of the sheep. I am the door. By me, if any man enter in, he shall be saved, and shall go in and out and find pasture. The thief cometh not but to steal and to kill and to destroy. I am come that they might have life, that they might have it more abundantly. Jesus Christ is the door, not Peter, not Muhammad, not Buddha, not sitting cross-legged waiting for aspirin, not Obama, not the Republicans. Jesus is the door of eternal life set forth for you by God. For the wages of sin is death, but the gift of God is Jesus Christ, our Lord. Friends, when you get to that pearly gate, you are not going to find a man there. You're going to find the man Christ Jesus there. And when you want to go through that pearly gate, you better have the blood of the Lord Jesus Christ, the Lamb of God, which take away the sin of the world. Eating wafers are not going to get you into heaven. Saying prayers will not get you into heaven. Selling magazines will not get you in heaven. But the precious blood of the Lord Jesus Christ without spot will get you into heaven. Again, I am the way, the truth, and the life. No man cometh unto the Father but by me. That's Jesus Christ. That's not me. And the same one that said, I'm the way, the truth, and the life, says, I am the door. And that door is shut to religion. Anybody else who comes and gives you another kind of door, he says, is a thief. Your religion is a thief. Liar. I am the good shepherd. The good shepherd giveth his life for the sheep. I am the good shepherd, and know my sheep, and are known of mine. The shepherd guides the sheep. I am the way. Come with me. light to the sheep. The truth. The shepherd seeks out those sheep that have been astray. He binds up the wounded sheep. The life. He takes the sheep to the Father. I am the way, the truth, and the life. No man cometh unto the Father but by the shepherd, by me, Jesus Christ. You can't walk up to God and say, "Hey, old man. Hey, Mr. Man upstairs. What's happening, bro?" You walk up to God with Jesus Christ leading you. If you don't have Jesus Christ, you are not appearing before God, because no sin can go in God's holy presence. You better have the bread. You better have the life. You better have the light. You better have the way. You better have the truth. Because if you don't, you will not get to the Father. Italian Papa Gino over there in Italy proclaims to be that shepherd. That guy can't even lead out of the bathtub. That guy can't even get his church out of sins of the priest. Just move him to another area. But I have a great high priest that can forgive me of my sins and wash them in the blood, because he is faithful and just. Jesus said unto her, "I am the resurrection and the life." I'm quoting from the Bible. You notice how all these verses back up with the verses that I've been reading about the verses over the verses. See, you don't want to read the Bible because you think you want God to be pleased with you, and the only way He can be pleased through you is through the Son, Jesus Christ. Because you are not good, for there is none good, no, not one. All unrighteous. He says, "I am the resurrection and the life. He that believeth in me, though he were dead, yet he shall live." Wait a minute. The last time I checked, when you're dead, you're dead. You don't live. My grandparents have died in the Lord, and they're in the ground. They ain't moving. I've got a wife that has died of cancer in the ground. She's not moving. Cemeteries are filled with dead people. They ain't moving. But Jesus said, "I am the resurrection." And with the word resurrection, he mentions the word death, so which means Jesus has the victory over death. And no one wants to die, because when you talk about death, you buy life insurance. Wait a minute. When I die, I don't get the money. If it's life insurance, give me the money before I die. Ever think about that? But when we're talking about death, and we're talking about Jesus Christ, and we're talking about salvation, let me open the Bible again. It's great with the Bible. You know I'm not lying to you. Because God never lies. And when I quote from God, it's safe. As soon as I get changed, but I would not have you to be ignorant, brethren, concerning them that are asleep. 1 Thessalonians 4:13-17. sleep, that ye sorrow not, even as others which have no hope. There are people who die who have no hope, because they died in their sins, they died without Christ, and they are in hell. That's no hope. For if we believe that Jesus died, where have you heard that before? That's the gospel. Christ died and rose again. Christ died, was buried according to the scriptures, and on the third day he was rose from the dead according to the scriptures. The scriptures match the scriptures, the verses upon the verses. I believe that Jesus died, and not only that, I believe he's seated at the right hand of the Father. He just said in John 11, I am the resurrection. Go find any religious figure right now and dig him up and you'll find his bones. You won't find a bone of Jesus. You can have a nail of Jesus, a splinter of the cross, you can have his robe, you can have the spear, but you do not have Jesus, because he's seated upon the right hand of the Father. Even so, them also which sleep in Jesus will God bring with him. When you die in Christ, you're absent from the body and present with the Lord. When you die without Christ, you wake up in hell. I hate to keep saying that word, but hell is real. All is not well, there is a hell, and Jesus is the way, the truth, and the life out of hell. For this we say unto you, by the word of the Lord, that's what I'm reading, that we which are alive and remain unto the coming of the Lord shall not prevent them which are asleep. For the Lord himself shall descend from heaven with a shout. Think I'm shouting. With the voice of the archangel, with the trump of God, the dead in Christ shall rise first. Jesus said, I'm the resurrection. And if you die in Christ, he will bring you out of that grave in victorious. Then we which are alive and remain shall be caught up together with them in the clouds. That's the rapture. Any moment right now, you would enjoy if this Bible dropped to the ground and blew away as we disappeared to be with Jesus. But if that were to happen right now, Jacob's trouble, the tribulation period, is not for Gentiles. Wherefore, comfort one another with these words. Death can be a comfort through the Lord Jesus Christ. He says, I am the resurrection and the life. I am come light into the world, that whosoever believeth, for God so loved the world that he gave his only begotten Son, that whosoever believeth, notice how the words are matching. Notice the verses with the verses with the verses. Believeth on me should not abide in darkness. Now he says should not, because there are Christians who live in darkness of their own doing. But if you were to do what the Lord Jesus Christ said, believe on him, and live the life that he has prescribed for us to live, there is no darkness, there is light. The Bible becomes alive. Believe it not. You here at the Daytona Farmers Market makes the Bible real to me every time we come. of your rejection of Jesus Christ, you back up the Bible. You prove Isaiah 53. You prove the people who walked and talked with Jesus as they cried, "Crucify him." You prove that there are more that will go the broad way than the few that will go through the straight gate. Straight gate, that's a door. Jesus said, "I am the door." But you all rather go the way of Broadway. A fast way, a hell way, to damnation is the Broadway. You want light. You want life. It's not in your psychiatrist. It's not in your president. It's not in your religious figure. It's not in your church. It's not even in you. Ye call me Master and Lord, and ye say, "Well, for so am I." Jesus is the only one to be held the title Master and Lord. The Bible even goes so far as to say, oh boy, ugly Americans, that you don't want to say this word, King of Kings. See, we don't want no king. Yeah, I know. I see you rejecting the king right now.
I worship the devil.
Yeah, he's a loser.
Yeah, just like you.
Lord of Lords. The title of Lord Jesus Christ, he is the King of Kings, Lord of Lords. If I were to update the Bible, and I'm not going to, I say he's the president of the president. I haven't heard one U.S. president stand up from the Oval Office on a Rose Garden and proclaim Jesus Christ as Lord. I had to read it in books. I had to use a magnifying glass to see it. I had never heard him openly profess Jesus Christ. I am not ashamed of the gospel. It's the power of life. You got a U.S. president standing here on the street corner just like we are, like the book of Acts, like Jesus. You know, he preached in the streets. He preached on the sand. He preached on the boats. He preached on the beach. He preached everywhere. I'm honored that God has given me the Daytona Beach Farmers Market Church. For where two or three are gathered together, Jesus is here. Don't make me break out a songbook. We'd be singing some good old hymns. Power in the blood. Are you washed in the blood? If I go and prepare a place for you, I will come again, rapture, and receive you unto myself, that where I am, there ye may be also. According to Acts chapter 1, Jesus is seated at the right hand of the Father, and if he says, "I'm going to come and get you," 1 Thessalonians chapter 4, "and you're going to be where I am, I'm going to be at the right hand of God the Father through the way, the truth, and the life. I'll be much closer than the cherubims. I will have an eternal presence with God the Father, God the Creator, the Lord Jehovah of all, because of Jesus Christ." My spiritual pants thinking about the glory of Jesus Christ and being with the Father. And I thank the Lord that he's given me his word and the ability to, and he says, "Go eat all the world and preach the gospel." Not food banks, not giving money, preach the gospel. And Jesus is the author. "Believest thou not that I am in the Father, and the Father in me? The words that I speak unto you, I speak not of myself, but the Father which dwelleth in me. the Father, and the Father in me, else believe me for the very work's sake. At that day ye shall know that I am in my Father, ye in me, and I in you. I am the true vine, and my Father is the husbandman. I am the true vine. You got any grapes over there? Grapes grow on a vine. And Jesus said, I am the true vine. Too many people think they're the tree, they're the plant. You want real fruit? You got to come to the vine. The vine is not Budweiser. The vine is not Michelob. The vine is not corrupt. The vine is new wine. New wine is when you take a grape and you squeeze it and you get grape juice. Another violation of the mass. Because the mass is hoop juice. It's fermented. It's poisoned. The true vine is the Lord Jesus Christ. I am the vine. Ye are the branches. He that abideth in me, I in him, the same bringeth forth much fruit, and without me ye can do nothing. If I took a branch and put it right here on the sidewalk, it's dead. It has been removed from the mother plant. It has been removed from the source. With a branch laying on the ground, there is no life. If it had fruit, the fruit would wither up and die. Yet there's coming a time when the harvest, when the angels have gathered those broken branches and cast them into the fire. And yet, as Jesus Christ is the vine, and you abide in that vine, you have life through the Lord Jesus Christ. And if you have studied science, which I have very little, in order to get life through the branches and the fruit, you've got to get through the vine. The nutrients, the water, comes through the vine to the branches. Jesus said, I am the way, the truth, and the life. No man cometh unto the Father but by me. Now, if in your heart, if you are hearing this message, and you really, truly want to do God good, you really want to do right, you really want to please God,